Ballot item number 29, second reading of Bill 78, an act to amend the Taxation Act 2007 to provide a tax credit to farmers for donating to Ontario Food Banks certain agricultural products they produced. Mr. Bailey.
Mr. Bailey.
Speaker, I move second reading of Bill 78, an act to amend the Taxation Act 2007 to provide a tax credit to farmers for donating to Ontario Food Banks certain agricultural products that they have produced.
Mr. Bailey moves second reading of Bill 78, an act to amend the Taxation Act 2007 to provide a tax credit to farmers for donating to Ontario Food Banks certain agricultural products that they have produced. The Honourable Member, Mr. Bailey, pursuant to Standing Order 98, has up to 12 minutes for his presentation. The Honourable Member for Sarnia-Lambton.
Well, Mr. Speaker, before I begin, I would like to welcome the following people to the Legislative Assembly today, all of whom have been instrumental in bringing Bill 78, the Taxation Amendment Act, Food Bank Donation Tax Credit for Farmers 2010, to fruition, or for lending their support to our efforts. I'd like at this time to welcome, and I'll just name them here and they can stand or wave, they're in the gallery and in the Speaker's gallery, Ed Borowski, Judy Dancos, Todd Jakes, Nicola Cernick, Basil Alexander, from the Ontario Association of Food Banks, Betty Jean Cruz in the Speaker's Gallery from the Ontario Federation of Agriculture, Captain Brenda Murray from the Salvation Army of Canada, Jamie Rome from the Holland Marsh Growers Association, Brenda LeClaire from the Chatham-Kent Outreach for Hunger Centre, Larry Brigham from the Regional Food Distribution Association in Thunder Bay, and Miles Vanney, who first brought this issue to my attention a year ago from my riding from the Inn of the Good Shepherd in Sarnia. I'd like to welcome them to the legislature today. Mr. Speaker, over the last 2 years, we Ontarians have found ourselves in the midst of a very difficult period as economic growth stagnated and unemployment increased rapidly across the country. While many of us weathered this storm by limiting our spending on the non-essentials, the unfortunate reality is that many households across Ontario have struggled and continue to struggle to this day to put food on their families' tables. In turn, many families have been forced to look to their local food bank for assistance. In May 2010, I introduced a bill to this assembly entitled the Taxation Amendment Credit, Food Banks Taxation Credit for Farmers, that, if passed, would provide a significant tax credit to farmers who donate their unsold produce and other excess food. While, Mr. Speaker, it may not solve the entire problem, I think it's a common sense solution to a clear need in my and many communities across Ontario. Mr. Speaker, I am proposing a simple change that will go a long way to relieve hunger and eliminate waste in our province. Inspired by similar programs in 10 U.S. states, my proposal legislation calls upon the Government of Ontario to institute a non-refundable tax credit worth 25% of the wholesale value of donated agricultural products to farmers who choose to donate their excess produce. This bill would also permit those unused tax credits to be carried forward and deducted for up to a five-year period. The extent of this need was driven home to me last March while I volunteered with Miles Vanney's food bank to serve meals at the Inn of the Good Shepherd in Sarnia. With my own eyes, Mr. Speaker, I saw the need in my own community for the role that food banks and soup kitchens provide. Through both local churches and other nonprofit organizations, these groups provide much-needed frontline help to many individuals and families who are in need through no fault of their own. Mr. Speaker, the unfortunate fact is that the Ontario Association of Food Banks reports that food bank usage in Ontario has increased by 20% in the last year alone. This means that roughly 375,000 Ontarians, our friends and neighbours, were forced to return to their local food bank every month in 2009. This, Mr. Speaker, is an all-time high for this province. Yet, perhaps more heart-wrenching than this figure is the fact that roughly 40% of those numbers are children who have to turn to this food banks for help. Unfortunately, as demand has increased, food banks across the province have seen a decrease in donations from large manufacturers and corporate food donors. In fact, food donations have decreased by more than £1 million in 2008 alone due to major food processors and food manufacturing plants in communities across the province closing their doors. Mr. Speaker, Most notably, the recession brought about the closure of both the Campbell's processing facility in Listowel, CanGro in St. David's in Exeter, and Quaker in Trenton. An example, Mr. Speaker, of this shortage was felt in the homeless shelter in Ottawa last July. It's my understanding, Mr. Speaker, for the first time in over 20 years, the volunteers at the Shepherds of Good Hope discovered that their cupboards were bare. They just didn't have enough food that day, and they were forced to stop serving food and lunch to those recipients who were lined up outside. However, what we often don't consider is the fact that even well-stocked food banks struggle with the ability to provide fresh, healthy food. In fact, the Ontario Association of Food Banks believes that over 72% of Ontarians who turn to food banks for help do not have access to the recommended daily servings of fruit and vegetables. And as we all know, proper nutrition is essential to our well-being. But more importantly, it is essential to the good health of our young people and children, who, as I noted previously, rank among the 40% of those assisted by these local food banks. Mr. Speaker, we open our hearts and wallets when we donate at Thanksgiving, and we donate at Christmas, and we donate at Easter. But for many food banks, a time of significant need occurs from June to August. Rarely do we think of our local food banks during the summer and autumn harvest. But what is most perplexing about this, Mr. Speaker, is this particular issue is that fact that while food banks struggle to provide those in need, Ontario farmers who are also struggling dispose of or plow back into their fields or send to landfill more than 25 million pounds of fresh, nutritious food each harvest. But why is this? Well, the answer in many instances, and the simple fact, is that much food left behind is considered seconds. While perfectly healthy, tasty, and fresh, the produce is often not chosen for sale because of cosmetic reasons such as size, shape, or color. So one is led to ask, why don't those in the farming community just donate this food today? Well, Mr. Speaker, some do, but the unfortunate fact in Ontario today is that in most cases, farmers cannot even afford the cost incurred to collect, process, and deliver the food to the food banks, despite a clear desire in the industry to do so. While farmers may wish to donate what remains of what they have grown, we simply cannot expect them to take a financial loss in order to pay hire the extra hands to glean and gather this excess food. Simply, we have the food, we just can't get it to those in need. My proposed legislation will provide a financial incentive for producers to donate. It will provide producers, at minimum, with a tax credit, which will help to offset some of the costs associated with growing and harvesting fresh produce. While in many cases, it will provide producers with a net financial benefit for the donation of those surplus food products. This proposed tax credit would reduce the producer's tax burden, which in turn should provide a strong incentive to make that donation. Furthermore, the proposed non-refundable tax credit, worth up to 25% of the wholesale value of donated agricultural products, will provide a high return of investment for the Ontario government. Simply put, it will cost the province very little in lost revenue. In fact, according to statistics gathered by the Ontario Association of Food Banks, it will cost roughly $750,000 in 2011 for an increase of up to 5 million tons of food. Mr. Speaker, these figures suggest that this simple tax credit could, in fact, provide a rate of return of $7 for every dollar donated. Moreover, this number should increase year over year as the program's profile increases. Mr. Speaker, I believe that my proposed bill presents a concrete solution which will not only assist local food banks, but also local farmers and struggling Ontarians who are our friends and neighbours. It will fight two problems in our province, hunger and waste. It is my hope that this piece of legislation, if passed, will help to both neutralize the cost placed on local farmers to collect and donate their excess produce, while at the same time provide a significant incentive to do so. Mr. Speaker, in turn, I would like to thank the outpouring of support that I have received in regards to Bill 73. I would especially like to thank the Ontario Federation of Agriculture, the Ontario Association of Food Banks, the Fruit and Vegetable Growers Association of Ontario, the Holland Marsh Growers, the Salvation Army, the Daily Food Bank, and many farmers and food banks across their province for their continued support. Mr. Speaker, I would also like to thank all the members, and especially the member from Northumberland, Quinty West, on the benches opposite for recognizing the simple wisdom of Bill 78 and also in advancing their resolution. And while I agree that a resolution may be a nice gesture, in the end, it provides nothing today for Ontario's agricultural community, and even less for those Ontarians who struggle to put food on their tables. Mr. Speaker, in this House today, We have the means today to do something concrete and positive for many people across the province who, through no fault of their own, are depending on food banks to feed their families. Thus, I would hope that the members of this House will assist me in moving this piece of legislation through the House to the benefit of Ontario's less fortunate. As my grandchildren would say, Mr. Speaker, Papa, this is a no-brainer. According to all figures and statistics, my bill will cost the government very little and provide great benefits to those in need in our province. Mr. Speaker, in 2009, Ontario farmers were forced to dispose of or plow back into their fields fresh, healthy produce, and at the same time, food banks went wanting across the province, seeing a drop in donations of over 1 million pounds of food a year and a drastic increase in food bank users. Mr. Speaker, if passed in 2011, my bill will cost less than $750,000 in lost revenue, while I'd our food banks with over 5 million pounds of fresh, nutritious produce. While it may not solve all the problems, it is a simple first step. Mr. Speaker, it's time to fight hunger with local food, so today I ask this chamber to act to help curb hunger and waste in our province by passing Bill 78. Let's send it to committee, where if there's improvements to make by additions or deletions to improve this bill, I'd ask that we advance it today, and let's all work for the good of the farmers, the food banks who have clients that certainly need this food, and all of our own constituencies. I know we have food banks in every constituency, and they're all in need. And I'd like to thank all the members who are here today for this debate, and I look forward to the rest of the debate. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Hey, there you go. Yep.